Good morning YouTube, what's going on? This is Enemans and in today's episode of How to Build Medieval, we are going to talk about materials you can use to make your building look more medieval. And I am sitting in the dark right now because my lamp just broke and... Anyway, the examples I'm going to show you today are going to be in the default texture pack and in John Smith, because those are the two that I usually use. But I will try to keep it more general so that what I'm talking about is not going to be texture pack specific. So our first block is the log, and depending on where you are building, you could think that the log should match the trees of the surrounding area, but I mean, it's logical because usually people wouldn't walk very far just to get a different type of wood. But on the other hand, it looks a bit boring if you just use the same block for everything. So if the trees and the houses are made out of the same block, it looks well, it's just and then the wooden block is just overused. So that's why I usually use different types of log, and also or most of the time I'm actually just using the normal oak wood because I like the texture the most, and I try to use it to create something like that looks like the pillars of a half timbered house. And you could say that the dark oak wood would be more realistic, since the wood was in the Middle Age, it was painted black. But I haven't played a lot in 1.7, so that's why most of my buildings are in the normal oak wood so far. And I don't really like the texture of the spruce wood, especially in John Smith. It looks, I don't know, I just don't like it. That's why I don't use it that much. But another idea could be that you use darker log combined with other dark materials. So I'm going to talk about that in the next few parts again. That you use darker log combined with other dark materials to get something that looks like an old building. For example, this abandoned village here is supposed to look quite old because the wood is old and rotten and stuff like that. And now I usually don't use the other types that much. First of all, the acacia block is new, just like the dark oak wood. I haven't used it a lot. And the only thing you could use it for, or the only thing that I can think of, is using it for an old building with the log that is supposed to look like it would be bleached, because the acacia texture is quite gray. So it's not really useful for normal buildings. Just like the jungle wood, and the reason for that is quite simple, because the Middle Age has taken place mostly in Europe, and there is just no jungle in Europe. So when you are using a texture pack that has a log texture that looks typical like jungle wood, then that does not really fit. And the birch wood wasn't used in real life a lot, because it wasn't very weatherproof, so you don't usually see it for buildings. And the other reason is that you just don't recognize it, because when you build with birch wood, it you cut off the bark, so that's why you don't see the typical texture it has in Minecraft. So that's just another block you should not really use if you want to build something medieval. Now our next block type are the wooden planks and the stairs and the half slabs and the fence, and there are quite a lot of wooden textured blocks, and I recommend using them a lot. And I actually do that because wood was just an easy to get resource. So you can use it for the walls of your buildings, or the roof, or the floor, or just fence to surround it. I don't know, there are quite a lot of ways using it. And if we take a look at Skyrim, I sometimes try to create something inspired by those buildings where there is a thatched roof with log on top of it holding the thatch down. And I do that by using a light wooden stair block combined with a darker one. So that's just a quick idea what you can do with the log. And also, again, I use the darker colored blocks to create something like rotten wood. And especially in John Smith, the spruce wood and the jungle wood look quite like they would be rotting and old. So that's maybe a good idea for using those. And the lighter wood is usually used by me for the inside of houses, so for a floor or a staircase, just as an example. And the acacia wooden plank is something I don't really want to use, because the default and default it's looking red, which is just a weird color for medieval wood. So maybe you could use it as an alternative for a brick roof, but again you have the brick block, so why would you use another red block? And in John Smith, for example, it looks just like another normal wooden plank, so I use it in John Smith but not in default. And now our third block that I want to talk about is the normal stone as well as the cobblestone. And just like the wood, it was just a natural resource which was easy to find. So for example, if you go on the outside for a walk, it happens quite fast that you find a stone in your shoe. And especially cobblestone was, especially cobblestone was used quite a lot in medieval buildings because it was easy to get, or easier to get than bigger rocks. So people just carried smaller rocks and combined them to get a wall for a building or something like that. And for example, especially if you take a look at Scotland, especially in the Highlands, there are those fences that are just completely made out of smaller stones and rocks. So they are not very good for making something like a roof because they usually look too heavy. You can use them to imitate something like slate tiles, but it happens quite fast that the roof looks just too heavy because you think of stone and, I don't know, not very good for a roof. But for walls it is quite useful, and you will see me use it a lot, especially when the building is supposed to withstand the weather, like for example a lighthouse, or if it has to withstand soldiers, like a castle. So that's when I usually use the stones. And now the stone bricks, which is our next block, are quite similar to the cobblestone, but they are just a bit more expensive because the bricks had to be crafted first, and people could not just pick them up like the cobblestone and combine them to a wall, but they had to cut them into blocks. So that's why they were more used for more expensive houses, like a noble house or fortified buildings, or castles, and that's just why stone bricks are tougher. And they also look better, so that's why I would use them just on castles or very expensive houses. And the stone slabs are quite good for a floor because they look, well, just quite simple. And you can also use the clean stone, but I usually prefer the stone slabs because there are also the half slabs, so they are, you can combine them to a small staircase or something like that. And you can use different kind of stone blocks to again create an abandoned effect, like for example this tower here is supposed to look broken, and that's why I used a lot of different textured stone blocks. And now our next block, or our next blocks, because they are quite a lot, are going to be those blocks who have a white texture, so like for example the wool or the quartz block or the clay or the snow. So there are quite a lot of blocks, and I use those blocks quite a lot for something like the white painted walls of a half timbered house. So combined with log and cobblestone and those white wool, I usually use it for building most of my houses. And as I've just said, I use the wool most of the time because there are not just the white wool but also darker colors. And especially in John Smith, I think it's the light gray wool block that has a slightly different texture, so that looks very good if you combine it with the normal wool. And the quartz block, I think it's supposed to look like marble, so that's what you probably want to use it for. And so maybe you could use it for something like a statue or a well in the middle of a marketplace. And you can also build quite cool structures out of that, because they are not just the normal blocks but also half slabs and stairs, so that's why you can make quite cool things out of that. And now our last block that I want to talk about is are the bricks. So they were used quite a lot in the Middle Ages, but I don't really recommend using them for building a wall, because today walls are still built out of bricks. And that's why when you build a brick wall, it does not look like a typical medieval building. It could be still a modern house, and that's why I usually just use them for making a roof. But if you are building a church, though, then you could use it as a wall as well, because churches are usually old, and when you see a church, you think of something old, so that fits into your medieval village or whatever you're building quite well, I guess. But other than that, I usually just use it for a roof, and in the default texture pack, I don't really like the texture because it looks like a modern brick, but in John Smith it looks kind of okay, I guess. So anyway, that were the blocks that I could think of and the blocks that I usually use. If there are more blocks that you think that might be interesting for building in a medieval style, then please write a comment about that. It might be interesting for the other people and as well as for me, because I usually try to improve my style with different blocks, because that is just what makes your buildings look more interesting if you use more different kind of blocks. So please write a comment and also try to give me some feedback if you like the series, what kind of parts you would like to see in the series. So the next thing I'm going to talk about are going to be the how to build your first medieval half-timbered house, I guess you could call it. So if there are other things that you want to know, then write a comment. I would probably make a video out of it, or just write back, I don't know. So with that being said, I would say thanks for watching and goodbye.